Hi, it's Monday, and Carly and I were out getting our hair done before vacation. We went to the grocery store to pick up stuff, and I want to show you how spring has been progressing here. But the landscaper guy came, and this guy, of course, he came with a crew. He wasn't like, you know, somebody just come by himself or a helper or whatever, and they did really good. They've been here since this morning. And I want to show you everything. So first of all, it's not a sunny day, so you're not really going to get all the nice color, and you know, sharp color, because it's overcast skies there. But he cleaned out these beds. Before we left, I was watching him clean out the beds. He cleaned them out so good, and put the mulch. He edged everywhere. Oh, look at this, how fabulous. And this is the whole area now that we have over here. We're gonna get Alex a real nice swing set. I wanna try to get a wood one if possible and put in here for him to play. And so they did all that. They cut our tree down. I missed that being blocked. I'm gonna see if I can get him to come and also clean up this bed and put mulch in there. And then my garden is ready. He did do my garden. I think they're supposed to come back. I hope that they're coming back because there's still weeds in the garden, and they're supposed to be cleaning up, not till it, but they're supposed to be cleaning this bed up and putting mulch in here too.
Let's go over.
It smells so nice and woodsy with all this mulch here. It smells good. I think he sprayed my weeds because I saw some of the weeds look like they're dying already, so that's good. And then in here, all that's, now this, I can do this myself, but see how this is hanging over here? I've got to trim that up. But look at, oh, how nice. And my spireas, my burning bushes, they're looking good. My azalea is bloomed. And then, of course, all my ferns and all that, they'll come back. Look how big that vine got since the last time I showed you guys, like about a week ago. And our poplar tree over there is bloomed, and he cleaned out that flower bed in the front there. Somebody's... Somebody's digging in the planter to find something to eat. And look who's looking very curiously. What do you see? Is that a squirrel? You're being very nice and not attacking the window. Don't scare him. Don't scare him. You're wagging your tail. That's nice. Don't scare him. I would throw him some nuts, but if I open the door, he's going to run away. I don't know what he's eating there. Look at the squirrel. Come here. Look. Do you see the squirrel? Ellie's being a good girl. Oh, he's leaving. He's gonna go out there now and dig in the dirt. He's behind the white post right there. He is. Good morning. It's Saturday. And oh, there's a big robin up on my shed roof. I don't know if they'll come over and eat. I haven't noticed any robins coming to eat at my birdseed area over here. I have this, you know, everybody has all different grocery stores. Like some people, you guys have Kroger. Some people have Winn-Dixie. Some people have Robertson's. We have Giant. And there's this Simply Enjoy, and it's Swiss chocolate. It's so good. And I can only have my chocolate-flavored coffee when Harry's not here. Because he likes just regular coffee. He doesn't like the flavors and that sort of thing. He's been gone all week. He's been in Chicago, back on our old stomping grounds. He's there on business, but he's coming home today. Today, I'm going to make some pizza dough here pretty soon. I was going to show you how I do my New York-style pizza dough recipe. So I'm hoping to come back to film that for you guys. So we're having homemade pizza today. I'm starting to gather things for packing. Like I already got my laundry soap little pod things and my fabric softener sheets, because I told you, if you bring your own soap, all that you're paying for is just to get the machines going. You don't have to buy the soap and all that. So I bring it and I tape it, because I told you, sometimes airport baggage people, they rifle through your stuff and they'll even take, you know, these and squeeze them so it goes out on your clothes. Shampoo, they do that too. Shampoo? I'm not even taking shampoo. I'm going to buy it when I get there, because that's the number one thing that they do. Is they open your shampoo. Not even conditioner, it's the shampoo, it's the soap stuff. They've done it to me a couple different times now, and they squirt it on my clothes, and I get, you know, really upset about that. But anyway, you can't do nothing about it. So, okay, so I have this. Adam's going to use this camera. I have his battery charged up there. I have another battery in here that's charged. These are my extra batteries for the camera that I'm using right now. I'm putting the camera cords in here. This is my phone charger cord, which will also go in here, but I'm going to be charging my phone before I go, so that just is going to stay there. I'll gather my computer at the last minute. Look at Lacey. She doesn't like thunderstorms, and she's still having some issues from this morning. You didn't like it, did you? Say, I don't like when it rains and it thunders. I don't. So, let's see, what else? Oh, I bought a bunch of snacks, and I just have them in the bag here. What we're going to do before we leave, maybe like even tomorrow night, everybody's just going to take whatever snacks that they like and throw them in their backpack, because I'm not taking this whole thing. Usually I'll take all the snacks, and I'm responsible for it and that, and so I'm going to let everybody be responsible for their own snacks. So we're not doing that. What else? Oh, so I'm doing my nails, and well, let me show you this way. So I got two coats of clear gel. Yeah, they have clear gel nail polish now, and I'm going to show you what I got. But anyway, the white part, you know how like they're doing French manicures, but they're doing them with colors now instead of just the white? So I'm going to do red on there. And then on my accent nail, I'll probably do black across, because your Mickey colors are pretty basically red and black. Those are the ones that we think of the most. And then the accent colors are like the yellow and the white. But we got this glitter stuff in here too. Carly went and had her nails done after work. She goes to this one nail salon all the time. And what they did with hers, she did like a Cinderella theme. Instead of getting like the design, the artwork on it, she didn't go through all that this time. Her accent nail is white. I'll have to show you when she comes down. The other ones are blue. It's like that Cinderella blue. And then at the tips, they put the nail glitter and the fan brush, like that's in that box there, and they take it and then they fan it down in there. And so I thought I'd get that done too, because then it'll be like pixie dust. Instead of doing all the designs and stuff, I did that on my toenails. Carly and I, we do our own like pedicure thing. But anyway, so that's what I'm going to do for my Disney themed nails. And what else? I think that's it. I'm working on laundry. It is not a laundry day. Saturday is not a laundry day, but I've done a couple loads of laundry. I have two more loads to do because this is last time that I'm doing laundry because tomorrow we got to pack. And what else? Harry's coming home and he'll have a suitcase full of dirty clothes because he's been gone all week. So later in the afternoon when he comes home, I'll have to do his laundry. So that'd be five loads of laundry I've done today. And so I'm working on that. I've mopped my floors and swept them. Everything's pretty basically dusted. I did that over the last couple days. I got to clean my bathroom down here, and I'm going to vacuum again. It was just a busy week, like I said, because the landscaper was here. Carly and I were doing grocery shopping for the last time, and not really, you know, for this week. We were just getting stuff for Harry and Brian for when we're gone. And then what else? We had Alex this week. It was really busy on Thursday because, okay, I think I've explained this before. With the early learning intervention program, there's the teacher, there's the speech therapist. And the speech teacher comes every week, speech therapist comes once a month. Then there's the coordinator that, you know, they got to check up on all the kids that the reports are being given to. And she shows up like once a month. Well, she's supposed to, but she wasn't here this month. And then now we have the social worker comes. The social worker, she comes because she, you know, surveys, you know, and takes note of like everything that you are doing for him. And she comes either two times a month for 1 hour, or she's going to try to come like she did this last Thursday, where she comes once a month because she's got a lot of kids and she's spread out all over. So if she comes here once a month, it's easier, but then she's got to stay for the 2 hours. And it was nice. I really like her. She's sweet. I like all of them, but I like her. She's a young girl and she's very talkative. So anyway, I like that. She's a person I can communicate to a little bit, you know? Let's see. So Thursday, the social worker was here for 2 hours. And then the teacher came a couple hours later and she was here for an hour. Okay, so I'm going to open my other blind over here. I didn't open this one. I was up and at it very early this morning, like at 4:30, something like that. And then finally it was a little after 5 o'clock and I said, you know what, instead of doing my shower later, I'm going to do my shower earlier today because I had to wash my hair and everything. And what I'm going to be doing around the house isn't going to be too terribly much. So I don't think I'll get sweaty or anything. I don't plan on going outside to do anything. So we have Alex's things all packed. I showed you that. And I got a new suitcase. Probably a lot of my video footage that I show, you'll probably see me gliding along because I told you guys the last time that we went, I got a scooter for a few of the days that I was there because the days that I go to Epcot, it's a lot of walking, and I told you my knees are getting kind of bad. You know, I have that one foot that's really bad too. And when you're on your feet walking all day, and trust me, I love the walking, and I really do love the walking because, especially with all the eating that you do, you never gain any weight. But because of like knee issues and my one foot, when you're walking through the parks, you know, day after day, and that's all you're doing from the time that you get up. Seriously, by the time you get up and go get breakfast, like at 7 o'clock, you sit down for breakfast, but then you're up, and then you're up, you know, and just only taking little breaks here and there. So it's just constant being on your feet and your legs, you know. So I would get like a scooter, especially when I went to Epcot, because that's the park that you really just do walking, because it's going through all the countries and stuff. And so when we went in September, even the first day that I got there, I got that rash on my legs. I've had it now three times, not the last three times, because I got it in September. The time we went before that was January. I didn't get it because it wasn't hot outside. It was nice and comfortable and cool. But then before that, the couple times before that, I got it. And they say some people just get it. It's because your sweat glands get clogged. And I've never had a problem with that ever going to Florida. And I've been going there since, you know, the 1980s. And I've never had a problem. But I'm hormonal a little bit because of menopausing. That's what I told Harry when I came back in September. And I showed you in the video, remember how horrid my legs look? I mean, that rash was on both of my legs. It was really bad. And the thing about that rash, it burns. I mean, you can wipe the sweat off and everything, but then you start walking again, you begin to sweat, and the sweat running down your legs and on your legs and all of that, you know how you get like clammy when it's real humid in humid places, and that, it's like fire on your legs. It burns really bad. And so, when I went the last time, let's just say this. When I went the last time, I didn't get a scooter, because, you know, we're at Magic Kingdom, and I just like walking the park. But I got that rash that first day. It was bad, but it wasn't really, really bad. But I didn't want to aggravate it, number one. Number two, the following day, we were going to Epcot anyway, so it was nice. I got my scooter, and guess what? All that redness started to subside, where it started turning like that purple color. Because it'll turn like a purple color if you don't aggravate it again. It starts to go away. It'll be gone like in a couple days. And so it goes from that real red to like a purple color. Almost like, you know, bruising or whatever, if that's what it kind of looks like. And I noticed because I was on that scooter and I wasn't walking, causing a lot of sweat, that the rash started to kind of like heal up and go away. But then the following day, I forget what park we were at, but I was walking again. And then with the sweating and all of that, and it was really bad. So then the last few days that I was there, I said, forget it. Because I noticed when I went to Epcot, and I wasn't walking, that didn't happen to me. So anyway, it's going to be in the 90s there. It's going to be hot. And I think the last 3 days that we're there, it's like, you know, in the upper 80s. But even in the upper 80s, it's the upper 80s, like close to 90, and you know, usually go over those temps anyway, so I'm sure it's going to be in the 90s. It's just going to be in the 90s the whole time. So, anyway, I told Harry, I said, I'm going to do it. I hate doing it. I hate spending the money for a scooter and all of that, but I said, I'm going to be on a scooter every single day. And I'm really bummed out because I really do like to walk the parks. I really enjoy it, but that rash, I'm not having that rash anymore, so I'll see how it goes. I'm sure by riding on that scooter, it'll keep that from happening, but like I said, it's painful because it burns really, really bad. So anyway, when I'm doing my videos, a lot of them, if I'm, you know, aiming the camera forward or something like that, it'll be like gliding along. So there's Carly's nails. See, with the glitter, and she watched how they did it, how they put the glitter on. They used the fan brush, and so we have that in our little, we have glitter in there, and we have the fan brush. Okay, I'm doing my pizza dough, and I've got three bowls here. I'm going to tell you why, because my pizza pans that I use, let me show them to you. These are the pizza pans that I use, and these are kind of like an extra large pizza. They're bigger than the just standard size pizza pans. So obviously, you need more dough than a regular size pizza pan. So to make four pizzas, one recipe will make two like regular standard, what, 12-inch pizzas or whatever it is. Or it will make like one large pizza, like if you put it in a cookie sheet, like you're doing Sicilian style. So since I do four pizzas, and this will make two pizzas, this one will make two pizzas, but for each of them, my four pizzas, I need a little bit more dough. So what I do is I take this and I do it in quarters and put a hunk with every, like when I split this in half, you see what I'm saying? A quarter of that will go there for one pizza. The other half, another quarter, will go over there. And that's how I'm able to get enough dough for my larger pizza pans. So that's why I have 3 bowls going on at one time. I've already started to proof my yeast, sugar, and water mixture. And all that is a quarter, wait, no, it's 1.5 cups of warm water, 1.5 cups. And then, so I dumped it in every one of those. Then you put in 1 tablespoon of sugar in those. And then you just need a packet of yeast in each one of these. Or if you're using yeast from the jar, it's 2 teaspoons and a quarter. Or you could even go up to half if you want to. So in here with my flour, this is 3 cups of flour and 1.5 teaspoon of salt. And so you can probably see the salt there. So I've got all this together here. I'm going to just mix all of this in like I always do when I make bread. Because yeast and salt, you don't want to put your yeast mixture right in with salt because it doesn't like salt. The only other ingredient that we need, excuse me, for each one of these bowls, so for each recipe, you'll need 4 tablespoons of olive oil. And I just do like a well. I'll pour in my 4 tablespoons of olive oil, and then like this yeast mixture I'll put in here. You can just mix it up and just knead it. I wanted to show you this brand of olive oil, and you can look up online what olive oil brands is really 100% olive oil. Supposedly there's been information going around that a lot of olive oil is not 100% pure olive oil. I didn't know if you guys knew that, but California, their brand, it's 100% olive oil. So this is the brand that I use. I used to use some of those other name brand olive oils till I found out that they weren't 100% pure. So I just wanted to pass that along to you guys in case you didn't know. And you can look that up online. Okay, I've had some of you friends comment when I make things you like when I show the step-by-step. So anyway, I've already put 1 dough together. This is the second one I'm doing. This is my 4 tablespoons of olive oil. So it goes right in the bowl. Carly's filming. You can lift that up and put it over here. And so what I do is I give it a little zhuzh around like that. Then I get my yeast mixture in there. And then I just begin to mix. And somebody asked me if I ever use the KitchenAid with like a dough hook. And I have in the past, but when I make bread, I like getting my hands in the dough. I like doing it the old-fashioned way because I like kneading bread. And I don't know, it just kind of makes you feel good that you're, you know, putting some effort into it. So this is mixed. And then what I'm going to do, probably I'm going to use about another 1/2 cup to 2/3 cup of flour. And you're just going to put it out there on your surface, and you're just going to knead it until you just get it like I've showed you, where you can pinch on it and you see, you know, your fingerprints retract back. Then you put it in your greased dish, put a little bit of olive oil on top, cover it up, and set it aside. It's 2:12 right now. I started mixing my dough and started letting it rise. It was about 11:30, so it hasn't even been a full hour. And I didn't show you, well, you did see how small it was. You didn't see how small it was in the bowl, but it's already doubled at this point. And I just let it rise all the way to the top. And then I'm going to divide it, and I get it on my pizza trays and spread it out like I was telling you, and let it rise again. And then right before I go to put it in the oven, putting it together, then, you know, because it'll come back down in here, you know, and then you can push it all the way over to the edge. So that's how I do it. But I just wanted to show you, it's only been about 45 minutes, and the dough has already like doubled in size. It's a quick rising dough. It doesn't take long at all. Okay, this is one recipe. So from one of those bowls, I took 1/2 of the dough, which would be 1 recipe. That's this. And then that last bowl where I divided up into 4 equal portions. So then, you know, every pan will get some of that dough. And then by the time that you're spreading it all over your pizza pan, it just goes on there real nice. And then you get a it's not a real thick crust, but then again, it's not a real thin crust. If I wouldn't do this, the crust would be super thin. And like I said, because these pizza pans are bigger, it's just better to just have that extra dough in there. So I'm going to spread them out on my pans. And it's 3:03 right now. I usually will begin putting them on my pans about an hour or so before I get ready to start putting them in the oven. And they only bake for like 20 minutes. So anyhow, yeah, I do it for about an hour ahead of time. Then it gives it a chance to, if it's going to start to shrink back a little bit, but at the same time it's going to start rising again, then when I go to do my pizzas, I can spread them out. And so I'll show you that. Okay, here's a sample of the one that I have on my stone. So, and you see how I have it all the way to the edges. Well, I had this all the way to the edges and that one too, that I just did those. And, you know, they're starting to pull in, but that's okay because the dough's going to rise again, and then you're going to be able to push it back up there and then throw your sauce and cheese and whatever you're going to have on your pizza. Okay, this is all my pizzas just after rising for like 25 minutes, that's all. So, spots that I need to fill in, I'll just fill them in like that. And I usually pinch my edges like this, so it helps keep the sauce from running over. And then over here, and see, you can see how much it's risen over here. Now it's thin here, and you can always, you know, push some of the dough out that way, but see, if you just do this, see, and now it's not gonna retract back down, and so you've got a nice, you know, raised edge and all of that. So anyhow, I'm going to take care of the rest of my pizza pans there and get my pizzas together. Okay, this is the egg pizza. See, can you see how big that is? See, that's like a huge pizza. So that's why I need so much dough. So I got a pepperoni pizza here ready to go in as soon as I take this one out in a couple minutes. And I just put the cheese pizza in there. So let me go ahead and cut this and I'll show you the crust. I don't know if you can see the steam coming off of that, because there you go, because it's really hot. So I love this egg pizza because it's kind of like a quiche. It's just eggs with some oil, and this is hot, and parsley. So eggs, oil, parsley, salt, some garlic powder. I wouldn't put fresh garlic in, just use garlic powder, and Parmesan cheese. You whip all that up, you spread it on top of your crust, and then I top it with some mozzarella cheese. But, so, let me get a look from this side. So you see that crust? Look at that. See, that's how I just love my pizza. And this right here, here, we'll go to the edge. See, it's got a little bit of a crunch here at the very end, but it's nice and soft through there. This is the excellent pizza dough. So if you like making homemade pizza, go ahead and give this pizza dough a try. I think you'll like it. It is 4:15. My pizzas are coming out. I'm gonna eat my dinner here with my kids. I'm going to clean up. Harry's gonna be coming home. I have to go upstairs and start organizing some more things, getting them together for packing. And then I'm going to try to go to bed early tonight so I get up early in the morning, because the earlier that I can wake up in the morning, and I'm talking about like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, and if I stay up all day, I'll be super tired when it's time to go to bed at night. And that's what we need, because we'll be getting up like about 3:15 to go to Florida. So tomorrow's just going to be, I'm going to pack, and it's going to be a rest up day, and Josiah's going to get Alex, and so we'll just have Alex running around here. It's just going to be a relaxing Sunday. So I probably might not vlog tomorrow. If I do, I might do a packing video. I've done packing videos before, but people tell me they like to see what I'm packing when I take my trips. So I might do a packing video. We'll see. But whether it's a packing video or I just start my vacation videos, I will see you guys next time.